Well, as I was talking about in my monologue a bit earlier, it's understood that one of the UK's most fanatical hate preachers is urging the Taliban to actually become stricter than they currently are. According to the Daily Mail, Anjem Choudary is proposing stoning adulterers, chopping off the hands of thieves, banning music, art and philosophy, and mixing between men and women. And it's also said that he wants non-Muslims to pay an infidel tax. Well, joining us now in the studio is Sam Armstrong, who's the Director of Communications for the Henry Jackson Society, an organisation which aims to tackle extremism, advanced democracy and real human rights. Well, thank you for joining us. What do you make of the fact that Anjem Choudary, he's gone to prison for 2 years after being convicted for terrorism. He had this ban. He's now had it taken off and he's just released this manifesto basically urging the Taliban to become even stricter.
Yeah, well, look, Anjem Choudary is the case that just makes a complete mockery of our terrorism laws. We know this guy is the most dangerous hate preacher we have ever seen. He's been tied to over 100 jihadists. Some of them have gone on to kill people, butcher people on British streets. We finally got him after years of trying to convict him for an offence that got him a mockery of a sentence, almost no time in prison at all. He was then on licensing conditions, very strict, couldn't do anything. The day they're lifted, he's out there giving a press conference and back to his usual tricks. But here's the worst thing. This system of light touch sentences, justice for our terrorist hate preachers has not ended yet. We've seen over the weekend, it is currently in this country not illegal to join the Taliban, to fundraise for the Taliban, to travel with the purposes of fighting for the Taliban. It is not illegal. The Home Office has forgotten to prescribe the Taliban. That is just, I think, in effect, how bad our terrorist system is in this country.
I mean, it's pretty shocking stuff, that, to be fair. Now, my understanding is that you can get arrested for hate speech if you tweet the wrong thing online, but apparently if you are essentially calling for jihad, then that's okay. Is that where we are?
Well, what you have is very clever people, lawyers like Anjem Choudary. He's a lawyer by background, and what he's an expert of finding the cracks, and they're moving faster than the very slow Home Office are capable of keeping up. And I think what people want to see is that the most dangerous people, who are actually not the fighters who are going and doing it themselves, but the recruiters, the leaders, are dealt with and tackled in a way that is commensurate with the damage they cause, which is innocent Brits butchered on our streets.
And on that note, in terms of a security risk, how much will he now be a security risk, especially given what's going on in Taliban? Do you think he is going to actively try to encourage terrorism on British streets?
Yeah, so Anjem Choudary can't do what he used to do, which is gather a group of young guys around him, network with them, influence them individually. He's being spied on too much by MI5 and others. What he can do, though, is he can act as this figurehead in the press. You know, he speaks, it gets attention, and it gives encouragement. It makes it feel to young people who might be sympathetic with these views that this is the call, this is the way to get ahead within modern British Islam. And the laws, the police, are just completely incapable of dealing with it.
Well, what's the solution then? Because I think, understandably, some people say, look, you can't just lock these people up and throw away the key, whatever my personal views on that may be. Some people say, well, you can't clearly let them carry on doing what they're doing. We can't really deport him anywhere. How do you solve a problem like Anjem?
Well, look, there's a few ideas. One of the clearest is, in the old days, we had these things called IPP sentences, where you get convicted of a very serious offence, you're not basically released until you're no longer dangerous. Within the jihadist terrorists, we know very clearly what that looks like. Those sentences were scrapped, and you can't use them, and they haven't been used for terrorists so far. The government could tomorrow, through legislation, bring back those sorts of sentences for terrorists. And then convicted terrorists like Anjem Choudary, he's now been convicted of the terrorist offence, would not be released until they'd proven they'd been able to be de-radicalised.
And just on this, that's a very difficult thing. The Fishmongers Hall terror attack, that man managed to convince everyone that he was a poster boy for de-radicalisation. Then, of course, he went on to kill a couple of people, didn't he, before eventually being shot dead. Now, this is the problem. You can never really tell if someone's been de-radicalised, can you?
No. The government have done some good stuff. They've brought in lie detectors, so you can ask people questions, and if the lie detector says they're failing, they're failing. But we've got a problem as well, that too many people in the de-radicalisation industry, and it's become an industry, have said, oh, well, he's de-radicalised, he just needs a few more courses with me and he'll be fine, keep paying us money and we'll keep churning them out good at the other end. And that has in and of itself become a massive problem, that there's lots of, frankly, at times, lefty progressive sorts that get into these schemes and let people out really quite scot-free, so long as the checks from the taxpayer keeps coming.
Maybe he needs to do a diversity and inclusion course. I think that'll fix
it. We obviously shouldn't make light of this. I'm not being sat next to Anjum Choudary at a diversity and inclusion course. I mean, I think there's a few places I'd rather be, to be fair. But do you see this issue going away anytime soon, in terms of, is it only going to get worse before it gets better?
Absolutely not. It is going to get much, much worse. There will be terrorist attacks on the streets of Britain within the next 2 to 3 years, guaranteed. Over time, with the Taliban taking over Afghanistan, we will be back to proper, well-trained terrorist bomb plots on the streets. We know that this is the case. When they've got the space to operate from, things get far, far, far worse. And that's what we've got coming.
Well, Sam, thank you for joining us. Really interesting, really quite worrying stuff. We'll keep on top of what he's doing. And he's clearly released this manifesto, and he's calling for all sorts of things in there.
Lots of people in full agreement with you on our emails. As you can imagine, gbviews@gbnews.uk. Please, we just need to get this guy out of the country. And that's from Alan. It's unfortunately much more complicated than that. Sam, thank you very, very much. Great to have you on board.